When I say Boker Tov, you say. When I say Boker Tov, you say.
Boker Or.
Everybody come on, come on. Everybody, oh yeah, oh yeah. Everybody, Boker Tov.
Boker Or.
Okay, let's see. I'm not sure we're all really awake yet. Let's do a two and we'll get louder and louder. When I say Boker Tov, you say. I say Boker Tov, you say? Everybody come on, come on. Everybody, oh yeah, oh yeah. Everybody, Boker Tov. Okay, now we're gonna get louder because we're waking ourselves up, right? So let's do a four. So it's pretty loud. You ready? Thumbs up if you're ready. Thumbs up if you're ready. Awesome. When I say Boker Tov, you say?
Boker Or.
When I say Boker Tov, you say?
Boker Or.
Everybody come on, come on. Everybody, oh yeah, oh yeah. Everybody, Boker Tov.
Boker Or.
Okay, guys, we're ready to wake up in the morning, and Mora Katrina is going to call on three friends to tell me what they do in the morning.
Yehuda.
Yehuda,
what do you do?
I do a costume party.
And what do you dress up as in your costume party, Yehuda?
He said a coffee party. He means pretend coffee.
Oh, a coffee party. Oh, I bet it smells lovely. Ready? When I wake up in the morning, I have a coffee party. When I wake up in the morning, I have a coffee party. Okay, everybody, I want to hear everybody still at our four. Boker Tov, Boker Tov, bo 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 Boker Tov, Boker Tov, Boker Tov, bo 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 Boker Tov. Okay, who's next to tell me something they do in the morning?
Rafi.
Yeah.
Rafi, what do you do in the morning?
Brush my teeth.
You brush your teeth. I'm so glad to hear this. When I wake up in the morning, I brush my teeth. When I wake up in the morning, I brush my teeth. Okay, guys, I want to hear you at a five. Let me hear it. Boker Tov, Boker Tov, bo 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 Boker Tov. Boker Tov, Boker Tov, bo 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 Boker Tov. Can I get one more friend to tell me this morning?
Shmuel,
what do you do when you wake up in the morning?
Well, you can't hear Shmuel. It's not unmuting.
Oh, Shmuel, your mic is muted. Is your mom nearby or your Abba to unmute the mic? There you are, Shmuel. What do you do when you wake up in the morning? Oh, say it again. You eat oatmeal? When I wake up in the morning, I eat oatmeal. When I wake up in the morning, I eat oatmeal. Boker Tov, Boker Tov, bo 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 Boker Tov. Boker Tov, Boker Tov, bo 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 Boker Tov. When I say Boker Tov, you say?
Boker Or.
When I say Boker Tov, you say?
Boker Or.
Let's see how fast we can go. Ready? Everybody, come on, come on. Everybody, oh yeah, oh yeah. Everybody, Boker Tov.
Boker Or.
Boker Tov, Yellow D. Thank you so much. Now we're going to go to Mora from me and then Mora Tehila for our daven.
Hi, everybody. Good morning. Okay, ready?
We open our sea door with love to thank Hashem from above. My heart is bursting with joy as I dive into you. Each letter is a gem, so precious to Hashem. I dive in with my sea door every single day. Each letter is a gem, so precious to Hashem. I dive in with my sea door every single day.
Yeah.
Good morning.
Are you ready for our alphabet? Let me just tuck these in here so I can turn the pages better. All right, here we go. Aleph, bet, bet, gimel, dalet, hey, gimel, dalet, hey, vav, zayin, chet, tet, vav, zayin, chet, tet, yud, kaf, chaf, lamed, mem, nun, lamed, mem, nun, samech, ayim, pei, fei, samech, ayim, pei, fei, tari, kuf, reish, tari, kuf, Ration, sin, tav. While I turn the page, you can all close your eyes and pretend to go to sleep. For Moda Ani, I'll get my ukulele. Are you ready? Close your eyes. Shh, pretend. Moda Ani, lefanecha, lelecha, nikayam, shehechazarta, dinishma. Thank you, Hashem, for all the... Can you make a big sun? Sunshine, and for the raindrops in the fall, and for the flowers, big stretch! Ah, that feels good. In the springtime, before the Torah, we thank you most of all. Give yourselves a hug like a Torah, and then hide your eyes. Open one eye, we open two. We say Moda Ani, cause it means thank you. We wash our yadayim 6 times, that's true. That's what every Jewish boy and girl must do. We raise our Shema up so high. We say the Shema, you and I. Hashem is one, Hashem is King. Hashem created everything. Ready? Cover your eyes and say Shema. El Melech Ne'eman. Shema Yisrael. Adonai Eloheinu. Adonai Echad. Baruch Shem Kavod Machuto Le'on Va'ed. If you have a Torah, you can hold your Torah now. Ready? Give it a big squeeze. Little Torah, let me hold you tight. Teach me all your mitzvot so I can do what's right. Torah teaches every Jew. Torah, Torah, I love you. Who's ready for some jumping? Should I get my friend Miriam out here? Miriam, want to jump with us? Yay! Okay, here we go. Torah, 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 Tzivalanu, Moshe! Torah, 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 Tzivalanu, Moshe! Moresha Kehila, Yaku! Moresha Kehila, Yaku! Moresha Kehila, Yaku! Torah, Tzivalanu, Moshe! Yeah, let's see. Miriam, you want to help me hold this?
Sure.
Oh, it's tzedakah time. So if you have tzedakah, you can get it now. You can get some money and your tzedakah box. If you don't have it, you can just pretend. Miriam, you want to hold this for me? Mm-hmm.
Tzedakah, tzedakah, tzedakah. This is what we give to the poor people to help them live. So they'll have food and clothes. So they'll have food and clothes. Even a penny a day will go a very long way. So they'll have food and clothes. So they'll have food and clothes. Even a penny a day will go a very long way.
Thank you, Miriam. Are you ready? And if you have a sister or brother or a mother or father with you, you can put your arms around them and we'll sing Ani Mamin. Ready?
Ani ma'amin, ani ma'amin, ani ma'amin. Be'emuna she'lema, be'viyat ha-mashiach, be'af al-pi she'yit ma'mech, ani ma'amin. Im kol zeh, achakelo v'chol yom sheyavo ani mamin. And I believe Mashiach is coming, even though it may take so long to bring us back to Eretz Yisrael, because that's where we belong. See you later, Miriam. Bye. Okay. On the page, we're going to sing our goodbye song, and then we'll go to our calendar with Mora Angela. It's such a good feeling to know you're alive. It's such a happy feeling. You have a neshama inside. And when you wake up ready to say, Moda Ani, to start my day. It's such a good feeling, a very good feeling. The feeling, you know, that I'll be here when the days are new. And I will have more mitzvahs to do. And you'll do things that make Hashem proud. I'm happy to be a Jew. Okay.
Good morning, my friend. I'm going to do a calendar with you. Are you ready?
Can't see it.
My friend.
Where is our vaccine?
Yesterday was Tuesday, April 28th. So that means that today is Wednesday, April 29th. So I'm going to put this up. I'm going to put it right there. Our calendar is coming to an end. I'm going to put on the number 29.
Mora Angela, Benji just wants you to notice something before.
What's up?
He just did his work, so he wants you to see that he got a sticker on his work.
Oh. We have share time after this.
She's going to do share time after calendar, okay? Okay.
I see it there, Benji. All right, my friends, let's sing our month. You can clap your hands, snap your fingers, or you can pat your knees. Ready? January, February, March, and April. April, May, and June, and July, and August, September, October, November, December. These are the months of the year. 12 months coming. 12 months coming. 12 months coming. These are the months of the year. Hi, Yosef. All right, my friends, let's do the days of the week. Yesterday we did the snap one, so today we're going to do there are seven. Ready? So there are seven. There are 7 days in a week. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Nice job, my friends.
Hi again. We're doing our lesson. We're going to tell you all about Eretz Yisrael. So I wanted to tell you that Eretz Yisrael is 72 years old today, but Eretz Yisrael was around a long time ago, and we learned all about it in our Parshiot of the year. So I wanted to remind you of the story of how the Jews came to live in Israel. So I'm going to show you some pictures, and then I'm going to make some drawings. Are you ready? Okay. Remember, a long, long time ago, there was a man named Avraham Avinu, and he looked at the world around him, and he recognized that there was Hashem. And because he was such a special tzaddik, and he looked at the world around him, Hashem decided to give him Eretz Yisrael. He told him to leave his home and go. And so he packed up everything, and he left where he lived. Can you imagine leaving Portland right now? Hashem says, let's go. And you just take a bag and go. Well, that's what Avraham did. And he left. And he went to Eretz Yisrael with his wife, Sarah. And they had a baby. They had Yitzchak. And Yitzchak married Rivka. And Rivka and Yaakov had two sons. Do you remember? Esav was red and hairy. And Yaakov learned Torah instead. And Esav and Yaakov both wanted to get the birthright of Eretz Yisrael. His father gave it to Yaakov instead. So Yaakov ran away because he was afraid that Esav was really, really mad at him. And he left and went to a place called Haran. where he met Rachel. There's the picture. But after a long time of living with Rachel and Leah, he left again to go back to Eretz Yisrael. See, it's been a long time already, and we've had three generations. You're like your grandpa and your grandma living in Eretz Yisrael, and now it would be your turn. So that was like Yaakov going back to Eretz Yisrael. He was a little bit worried, remember, that Esav would still be mad at him. So he sent him gifts, and he davened to Hashem. And then Esav gave him a hug, and he was able to come back to Eretz Yisrael. Now remember, Yaakov had 12 sons, and Yosef was his favorite. And one time Yosef had a dream that he was the middle stalk, and all of these stalks of wheat were bowing down to him. And he told his brothers the dream, and they got a little bit angry, and they sold him to some spice merchants. And the spice merchants took him to Mitzrayim. And that's how the Jews ended up in Mitzrayim. Well, when Yosef was in jail, he heard about Paro having a dream. And Paro told him his dream, and Yosef was able to explain it to him. And that was why Paro decided to have Yosef be his advisor and like a king in Mitzrayim. Well, when Yosef was like the king of Mitzrayim, his brothers came to visit him, and they didn't recognize him. And they had a happy reunion, and all of the Jews came down from Eretz Yisrael to Mitzrayim because there was no food in Eretz Yisrael. It's called a famine. And because there was no food, they all went down to Mitzrayim. But then there was a new Paro. I'm going to get my next book because it has it in there. There was a new Paro, and he was a little bit angry that there were so many Jews there. And he made them work really hard. Here we go. Building. He made them work so hard, and they were crying out to Hashem, Hashem, help us. And Paro even wanted to put all the baby boys in the river. And baby Moshe was born. You see the little baby Moshe there? And his mommy put him in the river, and Batya saw the baby and stretched out her hand and saved baby Moshe, and he was brought up in the palace. But one day, Moshe saw something, and he had to leave Mitzrayim. He had to run away, and he went to a place where he became a shepherd. A shepherd is somebody who takes care of sheep or goats like they have at the fisher's house. I remember one time when Moshe was up on the mountain and he saw this bush and it was burning, but it wasn't on fire. It didn't burn up. And then Hashem spoke to him and said, Moshe, go back to Mitzrayim and tell Paro to let my people go. Remember that? So Moshe went back down to Mitzrayim. All the makot happened. Dan, Sfardeya. Oh, look at all those frogs. Kinim, itching everywhere. Wild Arov. And Deber. Shin. Barad. And then grasshoppers, Arbe. All over the place. Choshech, remember darkness? All these things happened so that one night, Paro in pajamas in the middle of the night. Paro in pajamas in the middle of the night. Paro told them, leave! I'm done with these makot, go! And all the Jews packed so quickly. Remember, we just had Pesach. We packed so quickly that all we had to eat was matzah. We went all the way to the Yam Suf, and Hashem performed a nis, a miracle for us. And we crossed. Remember, the water opened up. And then we were in the desert. And we walked in the desert, and Hashem brought us to... which mountain would you choose? He brought us to a mountain called Har Sinai and gave us the Torah there. And even made it beautiful. Here's the Torah. And we were all there together, all of our neshamas, all of our souls. And Hashem even told us how to make all the beautiful parts of the Mishkan. And then we wandered in the desert for a long time until Moshe passed away, and he gave the rule to Yoshua. and Yoshua took everybody from the desert, from Har Sinai, where we got the Torah. We were in Mitzrayim, and we walked. We got to Har Sinai, and then from Har Sinai, we went into Eretz Yisrael with Yoshua, and we even got to a little city, and it had walls around it. And then we were able to conquer that, and we were in Eretz Yisrael, and we built the first Beit HaMikdash, the Beit HaMikdash, and it was so beautiful. And we all davened there, and we gave korbanos to Hashem. But then after a while, we didn't do so many mitzvahs, and we had to say goodbye to the Beit HaMikdash. It was destroyed. And there were some people from Babylonia, and they took all of us, not all of us, a lot of us, all the way to a place called Babylonia where we had Purim and Queen Esther. There's Queen Esther. Remember when we had Purim and Queen Esther helped save the Jews? Well, her son let us go back to Eretz Yisrael, and we built another Beit HaMikdash. Like my pictures. There's a door. Beautiful Beit HaMikdash. That was the second one. One, two. That was the second Beit HaMikdash. But then there was some people that were fighters and warriors, and they were called Romans. And they got rid of the second Beit HaMikdash. And they made us go to a place far, far away. Kind of like when Hashem told Abraham, come, let's go to Eretz Yisrael. But this time the Romans told us to leave Eretz Yisrael, and we had to go to a place called the Diaspora. And that means that there were Jews everywhere in the world. And we were in Europe, we were in Germany and Poland and Spain and everywhere all over the world. And then there was a lot of fighting all over the world, and the Jews decided that we needed to have a new home. And we decided that we needed our old home back. Eretz Yisrael. So in 1948, we went back to Eretz Yisrael, and now we have the birthday, and Eretz Yisrael is 72 years old. So all those things happened, but really, Eretz Yisrael was always our home, and there were always Jews living there. Even when a whole bunch of us had to leave, there were always Jews living in Eretz Yisrael. It is a holy place, and we love to live there. So we could sing happy birthday to Eretz Yisrael, and then we'll count the Omer, because I forgot to do that earlier. Ready? Hayom yom huledet, hayom yom huledet, hayom yom huledet, le Eretz Yisrael. Hayom yom huledet, hayom yom huledet, hayom yom huledet, le Eretz Yisrael. All right. So just like we were walking in the desert and finding Har Sinai, it took us 49 days. We're counting the days. Hayom yom echad, we're on our way. From Pesach until Shavuot time, 7 times 7 is 49. The days, the weeks are going by. We count all the days till we stood at Har Sinai. The day that we love is Chag HaShavuot, when Hashem gave us the Torah and Mitzvot. Want to help me count and decorate? Okay. Count with me, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. What comes after 19? 20. If you said 20, you are right. Here's a little bit of a pattern here. See if you can recognize what color I'm doing. It's dark pink for all the numbers that have a zero at the end. I'm gonna color it in. 2, 0 makes 20. Thanks for counting with me today. And now we're gonna go to do a story with more for me.
Hi, everybody.
Today we're going to be reading another book about Israel for Israel's birthday. Sammy Spider's First Trip to Israel. We love Sammy Spider in Tipo. This book is about the five senses. See, smell, touch, hear, and taste. Zip! A curious Sammy Spider peered down from his web as Josh Shapiro closed his suitcase. Mother asked Sammy, what is Josh doing? He's packing for his family's trip to Israel, answered Mrs. Spider. Will we go too? Asked Sammy. Silly little Sammy, laughed Mrs. Spider. Spiders don't fly to Israel. Spider spin webs. Sammy wasn't listening. He watched Mr. Shapiro give Josh a toy airplane. Thanks, explained Josh. Is this a model of the LL airplane that is flying us to Israel? Yes, nodded Mr. Shapiro. Now get your suitcase, Josh. We're leaving for the airport. Sammy lowered himself on a strand of webbing to get a closer look at the little airplane. He had just crawled inside the window above the wing when Josh picked up the airplane and dashed to the waiting taxi. Oh no, cried Mrs. Spider as Josh ran out the door carrying the plane with Sammy inside. She was not sure what to do. Keeping Sammy from exploring was as hopeless as keeping the sun from rising each morning. And she knew he wouldn't be traveling alone. From inside the little airplane, Sammy watched the big plane take off and fly above the clouds into the blue sky. He felt scared, but he couldn't help feeling a little bit excited too. Hours later, the plane landed at Ben-Gurion Airport. A taxi took the Shapiros to their Tel Aviv hotel. Shalom, said the taxi driver as they got in. Shalom, replied Mr. Shapiro. That's the Hebrew word for hello, he told Josh. After they unpacked, the Shapiros decided to walk along the beach. Josh put on his swimsuit and grabbed the little plane. Shalom, said the lifeguard. Shalom, replied Josh. Sammy smelled fresh sea air mingling with the aromas of Saiwa cafes and fruit stands. I wish my mother were here to enjoy the smells of Israel, he thought. That evening, the family strolled along Dizengoff Street. Josh had a little plane tucked under his arm. Shalom, said a sidewalk musician who was playing Israeli music on his guitar. Sammy loved the sound of the busy street. People speaking Hebrew, car horns honking, and tourists bargaining with shopkeepers. I wish my mother could hear the sounds of Israel, thought Sammy. The next morning, the Shapiros boarded a bus for Jerusalem. Shalom, said the bus driver. The bus stopped for lunch at a kibbutz. Many families live here together and farm the land, Mr. Shapiro told Josh as they gathered in the dining hall. The Shapiros ate falafel, hummus, pizza, olives, and pickles. For dessert, they ate halva. Sammy was hungry too. When everyone finished eating, he darted out of the little plane and sampled leftovers that had dropped to the floor. The pickles tasted sour, the olives salty, and the hummus and falafel were spicy. Best of all was the sweet halva. Back inside the plane, Sammy thought, I wish my mother were here to enjoy the taste of Israel. After lunch, Josh picked up his little plane and headed for the kibbutz farm. A cow grazing with her cock calf and a hen clucking to her chicks reminded Sammy how much he missed his mother. Silly little Sammy, he could hear her say. Have fun. I'll see you soon. When the group reboarded the bus, the kibbutz families waved goodbye and shouted shalom. Shalom also means goodbye, Mrs. Shapiro told Josh. The bus climbed the hilly road to Jerusalem. As they rounded a curve, the afternoon sun glistened off the stone buildings. We're here, announced the bus driver. Wow, it looks like a golden city, Sammy exclaimed to himself. If only my mother could see Israel too. The western wall is all that is left of the Holy Temple in Jerusalem, the guide exclaimed. Oh, the bus reached Old City. The Shapiros got off and walked the narrow alleyways to the Jewish quarter. The western wall is all that is left of the Holy Temple in Jerusalem, the guide explained. Shalom, said the young soldier at the checkpoint. Shalom, Josh replied. Josh and his father walked toward the wall. Sammy saw some people praying. Others were tucking little notes between the huge stone blocks. They have written special prayers, Mr. Shapiro told Josh. Sammy crawled out of the little plane onto the wall. The huge stones felt hard and rugged, yet in the cracks between them, Sammy noticed little plants were growing. It's just like the land of Israel, thought Sammy. Hard and rugged, yet a special home to all Jews. I wish my mother were here to touch and feel Israel. He wanted to tuck his own prayer in the wall, but he knew what his mother would say. Silly little Sammy. Spiders don't write prayers. Spiders spin webs. And that's exactly what he did.
Three or four words.
The days passed quickly. The Shapiros traveled all over Israel, and Sammy went along snug and safe in Josh's little plate. They rode camels in the Negev desert, and Sammy felt the soft wool of the animals. They snorkeled off the beaches of Eilat, and Sammy saw the colorful fish. They stopped at a date farm in the Galilee, and Sammy tasted the sweet fruit. They floated in the Dead Sea, and Sammy smelled the salty water. On Shabbat, they time to fly home. Sammy was eager to see his mother and share his adventures. When the Shapiros arrived at the house, Josh ran inside and put the little earpin on the couch. Sammy crawled out and shouted, "Mother, I'm home." Mrs. Spider scrambled down to embrace Sammy. "I'm so glad you're back. I missed you so much," he said. "I missed you too," replied Sammy. "I wish you had been with me to smell the seer of Tel Aviv, hear Israeli music, taste the delicious falafel, see the golden city of Jerusalem, and touch the Western Wall, the Kotel. And I have a new word to teach you. Shalom is a special Hebrew word which means hello, goodbye, and peace." Sammy rubbed his eyes and yawned. Mrs. Spider gently carried sleepy Sammy back to their web. As she tucked him in, she whispered softly, "Shalom, little Sammy. Hello, welcome back, and sleep peacefully." Okay, Morty is going to sing our goodbye song.
Thank you for joining us today. Tomorrow, Mora Angela is going to do a lesson on all the different things, or some of the different things, that you can make out of toilet paper rolls. It sounds like it's going to be so exciting. And Mora Tehila will continue with the counting of the Omer. You all ready to sing with me? Thumbs up if you're ready. Shalom chaverim, shalom chaverim, shalom, shalom, lehitraot, lehitraot, shalom, shalom. Goodbye, my friends, have peace, my friends, have peace, till we meet again, till we meet again, have peace. Have peace. Shalom chaverim, shalom chaverim, shalom, shalom. Lehitraot, lehitraot, shalom, 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 shalom. Thank you for joining us today. I'd like to invite the Mayim class to stay on for a special share time with Mora Angela. See you the rest of you tomorrow.